Welcome back to our YouTube channel. It's just Kathy from Kathy and Steve here today. And I'm really excited to share with you a new project I did for Delilah's School Tea Luncheon. It was some decoupage vases using these blue china napkins and Mod Podge, of course. Unfortunately, I don't have any of the vases to hold up and show you because they were so popular at the tea party that everybody took them. I had a dozen vases and they're gone. I didn't even have one to bring home, but that's fine because I was really, you know, honestly, I don't need to look at them anymore. I took a great photo. The napkins were left over from our last furniture flip. So if you check that out over at Plaid Crafts, you will see that we use these same napkins to do an outdoor patio set with the outdoor formula Mod Podge, and that turned out so cool. And I had spares, so I've been using them for everything. I covered wood beads with them. Can you see those wood beads last night? And this was another fun thing I did, just these art containers. And these were yogurt and milk and juice containers. And I painted them with Folk Art chalk paint and then covered them. So I've got a couple tutorials. I'm gonna show you how I did the vases and I'm going to show you how I did the art buckets. And you could use any napkin for this, but we had a tea party, so it was perfectly fitting for that. So let's get on with the tutorial. I picked up the vases at the dollar store and they were these bright colors, but not what we wanted for our tea party. Next, I used Folk Art Home Decor chalk to prime the vases white. Remember, when working with napkins, you're only using the one printed ply. I use Mod Podge satin for this project. In addition to the vases, I made some signage for the party using the school's mascot. It was the same technique, but I used a wood plaque instead of a vase. And don't forget about those cute crayon and marker buckets. They started out as old recycled food containers. I cleaned them up and I trimmed them down to size. Then I used that same paint as a primer on them and did the same technique with the napkins.
Thanks for popping by today. I really hope that you enjoyed this napkin tutorial. And remember, just whatever napkin you choose, that's gonna create the design. I think this is a great idea if you're planning any kind of a party and you wanna coordinate a look, or a wedding shower, or baby shower, or a wedding. It's endless what you can do with napkins. And honestly, they're so reasonably priced. It's such a cool technique. Be sure to subscribe, give us a thumbs up, and ask any questions, and I will be sure to answer them. See you next time.